We as gamers are quick to jump on the hype train for upcoming games, but sometimes we end up getting ourselves hyped over just the idea of an upcoming game. What is up, everybody? Chaos here, and today we're going to be looking at 10 of the biggest unconfirmed games in the world right now. This list is going to be comprised of games that people are super hyped for, but there's not actually any word on their existence as of the recording of this video. And be sure to let me know if I miss any in the comments below. Let's get right into it. Kicking off our list at number 10 is Wolfenstein 3. That's right, the conclusion to the rebooted Wolfenstein trilogy, which has gotten tons of new fans into the franchise and tons of older fans have came back. Now, the rebooted series kicked off with Wolfenstein The New Order in 2015, then it was continued upon with Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus. However, The New Colossus left a massive, massive cliffhanger at the end, and as of the recording of this video, there is no official word from Bethesda that the conclusion is actually on the way. At E3 2018, we got a quick glimpse of a spin-off called Wolfenstein Youngblood, but no actual word on the main storyline's conclusion, and hopefully it didn't get canned without anybody knowing. And I can't see how it would. The other two went over really, really well. So we'll just have to wait and see. And if you're a Wolfenstein fan, keep your fingers crossed. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 9, Dark Souls 4. Next up, we have a game that I know tons and tons of people are eagerly waiting for, although you guys might be waiting for a while. Dark Souls is an action RPG series that has gained a rep for being insanely hard but having a super interesting lore and very rewarding gameplay and world building. Everyone has their own opinion of which Dark Souls game is the best and which is the hardest. I want to know from you in the comment section which one is the hardest. And we got some news a couple years back that there, well, it was kind of good and bad. According to the president of From Software, the team behind the series, he said the Dark Souls series was being put on hold for a while. However, he did not say that they were finished or that they wouldn't finish. So the good news is there is another Dark Souls game coming somewhere in the future. The bad news is it may not be for a few years. At number 8, and we have no confirmation, but you know this is happening, Mortal Kombat 11. Now, Mortal Kombat has been an up and down series when you think about it. The original games are a ton of fun, and the new series is excellent. But the games in the middle, well, they were kind of hit and miss. Some were decent, some were trash. I don't think anybody would disagree that MKX was an awesome addition to the franchise, and it's still being played competitively to this day in major tournament circuits. Regardless of how much you may or may not like NetherRealm's new MK series, it has been over 3 years since MKX was released, and I think it's only a matter of time until we get the reveal for MK11. Now, it's kind of hard to think of what else could be added since MK9 and X had so much content, but hopefully this time around, they can fix up the server quality because both of NetherRealm's MK games have suffered a bit in the online play department, and everybody always looks forward to the fatalities. At number 7, Modern Warfare 4. Activision never likes to get too ahead of themselves when it comes to announcing new COD games, but they're also not too great at keeping secrets. Despite the fact that this year's game is Black Ops 4 and it's still a few months from being released, there have been countless leaks pointing towards next year's Call of Duty game being Modern Warfare 4, the long-awaited continuation to the legendary Modern Warfare trilogy that helped shape the military FPS genre as we all know it. Plus, with all the strange things that Treyarch is making, well, doing to the COD formula with Black Ops 4, many fans of the series are just skipping this game's hype train and holding out for Modern Warfare 4. So what do you guys think? Are you more excited for BO4 or MW4? Speaking of Modern Warfare, this one is a given, Modern Warfare 2 Remastered. Now, honestly, I have no clue why Activision isn't saying anything about this game because we all know it's coming. Modern Warfare 2 is one of the most popular games ever made, and after the first MW game was remastered a couple years ago, people have been anxious to hear whether or not the sequel was going to get the same treatment. Then, over the last few months, we've been getting tons of leaks from retailers, development studios, industry analysts, and more and more and more about the remaster of Modern Warfare 2, but Activision still has not said a word. I don't know what's taking them so long to acknowledge this because, I mean, come on, we all know it's coming. Cracking into the top 5 today, Bloodborne 2. I mentioned earlier that Dark Souls 4 may be a long way off. However, fans of the Souls series may be getting some new Souls-style gameplay sooner than having to wait for DS4. Back in 2015, we got a new game from the mind of the Dark Souls creator called Bloodborne, and it was a huge hit. For a while, it was even the main reason to own a PlayStation 4. I think it's safe to say that Bloodborne 2 is going to be coming soon, but it's mainly a question of when. We know that Sony has really been pushing Spider-Man and The Last of Us 2 recently, so they probably don't want to add another game to the hype train right now. But if you ask me, I think we're going to start getting teases and hints towards Bloodborne 2 a little bit after Spider-Man launches. Speaking of Sony, man, God of War 2. I know, we didn't get God of War very long ago, but they made a crap ton of money off of this game, and when you make a lot of money, you do a sequel. The God of War reboot was an excellent reimagining of Kratos and his story and came along with the total redo of the gameplay and the world building. It had a great story, it had fun gameplay, and it sold more than 5 million copies within the first month. So is Sony going to sequel it? Duh. However, since the game only launched a few months ago, they're probably holding off on an official confirmation until next year at the absolute earliest in order to let the market die down a bit. And also, they don't want to take hype away from, like we said earlier, Spider-Man or The Last of Two. But no confirmation, but I can guarantee you that God of War 2 will be coming, especially with the cliffhangers that we got at the end of God of War. At number 3, speaking of reboots, Resident Evil 7 was a great soft reboot of the Resident Evil series from 2017 that got the franchise back to its horror roots. Now, I'm talking about Resident Evil 8. The RE series has been struggling ever since RE4 due to Capcom insisting that they turn up the action and turn down the horror. And RE7 was the first game in a long time to actually acknowledge that problem and fix it. However, fans are still skeptical of the eventual Resident Evil 8 because Capcom has this habit of doing dumb things to a franchise and then not actually listening to the fans when they say they don't like it. See Resident Evil, see Street Fighter, Marvel vs. Capcom, you guys get the gist. RE7 got the franchise back on track, but RE8 is going to be the main deciding factor of whether or not it stays on track. And hopefully, Capcom doesn't fall back into the bad habits in the future. If a model's not broke, don't try to fix it. You can tweak it, but don't try to overhaul it. If you've been following me for a while, you probably know I love Borderlands. The original Borderlands and Borderlands 2 were amazing, and me and a lot of you are waiting for Borderlands 3. The first two Borderlands games, I mean, they were fun. They hours and hours of entertainment thanks to awesome gun design, gameplay, and writing. However, it is no secret the developers Gearbox have been struggling outside of the Borderlands franchise. Ever since the first Borderlands game was released, Gearbox has also released, you ready for this list? Duke Nukem Forever, Aliens Colonial Marines, and Battleborn 3, of the biggest disappointments in the gaming industry. I mean, seriously, that's an incredible list. So I think it's fair to be a little worried about the state of Borderlands 3. And regardless of Gearbox's current state, I'm excited for the future of the series and what it has to offer when it finally does come out. And I strongly feel that we will eventually get Borderlands 3. They need it. They need to resurrect their developing studio. And at number one today, GTA 6. Finishing off our list is a game that people are looking way ahead for, but honestly, I can't blame them. Red Dead Redemption isn't even out yet. We're already talking and getting series of leaks about the next GTA game to get hyped over. If the leaks are to be believed, GTA 6 is going to be bringing us back to Vice City in the 1980s and will feature a massive map, or maybe even multiple maps that span both the southeastern United States as well as some of South America. The only catch is that GTA 6 reportedly won't be out for another 4 years, and fans are already hyped for it. Can you blame them though? When was the last time a GTA game didn't give you hours and hours upon hours of entertainment? Hell, GTA 5 is still one of the most popular games in the world thanks to the ever-expanding GTA Online mode. And Rockstar has stated they are going to continue supporting and updating it even after RDR 2 launches in a few months. Now, I'm definitely excited for the official news of GTA 6, but I think we're going to be waiting a long, long time for it. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 of the biggest unconfirmed games. We have no confirmation. It's all speculation, but hopefully they're all coming. Let me know, one game on this list, if you could pick, if you had the power to choose and make it reality, which game on this list would you guys choose? If you enjoyed the video, take a second, drop a like, make sure you're subscribed and turn on those notifications, because that's not unconfirmed. It is confirmed that if you turn on the notifications, that is how you actually get the videos on YouTube. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you soon.